Hello friends, today we will learn about the hydraulic system. Here you can see motor to drive a hydraulic pump. This is hydraulic system of kiln cooler grade. Here you can see four motors, three for the cooler grade 1, 2 and 3, and one is spare. This is the hydraulic oil tank. Here you can see the instrument RTD for temperature of the oil tank. This is a level switch for detect the level of tank. This is RTD for temperature. Glass level for physical inspection of the oil level. As you can see, filter and differential pressure switch installed on filter. These are the valve and limit switch to show that valve is open or closed. Normally all the valves should be open. This is the pump. This is a DC proportional valve. It gives the strokes to the jack. We give the set point that how much stroke it should give to the jack, so it will drive the jack on the same set point. These are the gauges which show how much pressure to drive the jack. If overloaded, pressure will be more. This is gauge for reverse and forward. There is a pressure switch to indicate the pressure in CCR. Overload will create more pressure, so we can check the system. Range of the pressure transmitter is 0 to 250 bar. This is the connection of this DC proportional valve. I will remove this DC proportional valve and I will show you what is inside this proportional valve. These pipes goes to the pneumatic jacks. These red color pipes you can see. So this is the overview of this hydraulic system. These pipes deliver pressure to jack reverse or forward, and it gives proportional valve gives strokes in these pipes, so the jack moves forward and reverse. Here you can see on the gauge pressure going reverse and forward. One gauge is for reverse and one for forward. This is tonnage panel of this hydraulic system. You can see that we can start stop manually or by CCR. You can see pressure is showing, feedback is showing, and set point to the hydraulic jack is showing all three grades. Speed is there, pressure and feedback of the speed. This is back side of this touch panel. Here is Siemens PLC. This is a local PLC to drive this hydraulic system. Breakers for the main supply and supply of this PLC and the different instruments. So this is the input output cards. Breakers for supply. This is a power supply, 220 volt input and 24 volt output. These are signal isolators. their input is 4 to 20 milliamps and the same 4 to 20 milliamps output but the isolation between two panels. These are relays for output and this is the terminal blocks as you can see. So this is the panel. Now I will show you hydraulic jacks. How these hydraulic jacks are moving, I will show you. Here you can see hydraulic oil pump and connections are with the jacks and jack is moving reverse and forward as per the set point. Same in the strokes of this hydraulic jack by the compression valve. Calculate the strokes. Now I will. This is a DC proportional valve by the Porter made Germany. As you can see, its electronic card inside this box. We will remove these bolts and we will take out its spool. I will show you how this spool is made and what the problem. Normally in it I have removed the bolts. Here you can see there is a spring. As you can see, this is spring to push the spool. Now I am pulling the spool outside. I will pull back the spool. Here you can see the washer which is pressed by the spring to keep the spool in its position. I am removing the spool. Take out very carefully. It's very sensitive and any damage on it may cause that the DC proportional valve will not work. You can see the spool. Just like SUV plunger. Now I will remove, dismantle this complete DC proportional valve and I will show you its important parts. Here you can see I am removing the bolts. Four bolts and two in the center, total six bolts. I have removed the four in the cross. Now I will remove the two in the center. One is in front of me and the other is on the opposite side. Here I am removing these bolts. So I will show you how to service this DC proportional valve made by Porker Germany. Its supply is 24 volt and it has a set point and a feedback. As per set point it gives the stroke to the jack. Now I am dismantling it from its mechanical block. Here you can see there is a little dust type material and the oil is not clean. I will clean this block. We have also need to clean this proportional valve body. Here you can see the oil connections, oil ports, there are oil seals. So this proportional valve just change the way of oil. Here I am showing you oil seal. It's in good condition, so no need to replace. This is the spool. You can see a black type material. This is due to oil is not clean, so this may cause the stucking of this spool. I will clean the spool with diesel and also the body of this proportional valve. As you can see, I am pouring diesel in it. I will clean it so the material, dust type material in it, can be clean. You can see the black oil because there is some material inside. I am cleaning it properly. Now I will remove these four bolts. This is the coil. This proportional valve has two coils, one to stroke it forward and one to stroke it reverse. So the electronic circuit of this proportional valve, as per the set point, change the coil supply and oil goes to the reverse or the forward side of the hydraulic jack. I am removing this coil. It produces magnet to move the spindle reverse and forward, so the main spool moves and supply of the oil changes reverse or forward to the jack. Here you can see cables for the supply of the coil. This is 5 volt supply. This coil is operated with 5 volts. I have removed it. Here you can see a pin that moves with the magnet of coil. It's just like SOV, so it moves the spindle left or right. We have to clean this pin and we also need to clean the spool. Here inside spool, I will remove it and I will show you. Now I am removing the other coil so we can clean both sides and the maintenance of this DC proportional valve will be completed. After the cleaning, I will check the condition of plunger inside. I am removing the plunger. We just need to push it from one side or pull it. It's little stuck. I will push it from the other side. Yes, now it is free. There you can see, just like SOV, it has a plunger. So when coils operates, supply of oil changes and the jack moves forward or reverse. It also need cleaning. I will clean it with diesel. After cleaning, I fixed it back. I have also cleaned the block. Now I am installing DC proportional valve back to its position. So this is the way how we can service a DC proportional valve. I have shown you its internal parts. This is the jack for the supply and set point and for the feedback of DC proportional valve.